Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 10.4, Problem 2. This is Section 10.4, Problem 2. It says use the rules of exponents to simplify each of the following. And there's six different things that look fairly similar. They all have some type of 2 to the 4th, some positives, some negatives, but there are differences. Part A, you have negative 2 to the 4th power. And if you notice, Part B is also a negative 2 to the 4th power, the difference of the parentheses. And the top one, A, negative 2 to the 4th power, the negative is not being raised to the 4th power, only the 2. So really what you have, the negative stays out front, and you have 2 to the 4th. So you have 2 times itself 4 times. So 2, 4, 8, 16. The answer is negative 16. Now B looks so similar, you have negative 2 in parentheses to the 4th power. There's a big difference because now that 4th power is affecting the negative and not only the 2. So part B, negative 2 in parentheses to the 4th power is negative 2 times itself 4 times. Negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. Again, now the 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 again is 8, times 2 again is 16, but now the even number of negatives cancel out, and the answer for part B is positive 16, as opposed to part A, which was negative 16. These two look very similar, but one's positive, one's negative, and that's a very common mistake. Without the parentheses, it's only the value next to the exponent that's being affected by the exponent. With the parentheses, they're both being affected by the exponent. That's a key difference. Now, part C is 2 to the negative 4th power. So, again, it looks similar. Now the negative is moved up into the exponent. What that does, the rule for negative exponents says if you have something to a negative exponent, it's not that it's positive or negative. It's just telling you whether the exponent actually occurs in the numerator or denominator of the problem. This is really 1 over 2 to the positive 4. That's what 2 to the negative 4th means. So 1 over 2 to the positive 4 is 1 over 2 times itself 4 times. So it's 1 over 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is 1 over 16, or 1 16th. Now, part D, again, they all look pretty similar. This is 1 over 2 to the negative 4th. So when the negative exponent occurs in the denominator, again, it's not that the value is positive or negative, it's telling you that you should move it to the other position. You should move from the denominator up to the numerator, so what you really have is 2 to the positive 4. Some math teachers refer to this as the elevator rule. You get to ride the elevator, but you pay the elevator toll. The toll is you have to change the sign of your exponent to the opposite of whatever it is. So you ride back up to the top floor, but the toll you pay is it becomes a positive 4th power. Now 2 to the 4th is just 2 times itself 4 times. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. So again, 2, 4, 8, 16, when you multiply it out, the answer for 1 over 2 to the negative 4th is just 16. And now part E, again, you have the same, basically the same ingredients, but they're arranged different ways. So you have 1 half to the 4th power. And because it's a fraction, it looks like it's kind of tough, but it's really 1 half to the 4th power is 1 half times itself 4 times. So 1 half times 1 half times 1 half times 1 half again. And now when you multiply fractions, you multiply top times top, bottom times bottom. So across top, 1 times 1 times 1 times 1, you have 1. And then the bottom, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 again is 8, times the last 2 is 16. So 1 half to the 4th power has an answer, 1 16th. And finally, the last part, part F, you have 1 half to the negative 4th power. So, again, this rule with the exponent, what you really have is 1 over 1 half to the 4th power. And that's 1 over 1 half times 1 half times 1 half times 1 half, 4 1 halves, which is 1 over 1 16th. Now, that is the answer, but it's really not in its simplest form. If you remember from any previous math classes, when you have a fraction that's in the denominator of a bigger fraction, what you do is you flip, or the more correct word is invert, the bottom fraction and multiply it times the top. So when you invert it, you have 16 over 1, or just 16 times the top, which is 1. So 16 times 1. This messy looking thing just comes out to plain old 16.